Today we're getting sparkly with some vintage Weiss jewelry. There is so much vintage costume jewelry out there to love, and one of the great designers was Albert Weiss. A lot of times when people think of vintage jewelry, they think of rhinestones all clustered together, and that is really Weiss. That is Weiss's specialty. Weiss was founded by Albert Weiss in 1942. He was a New Yorker, and he opened his first store on Fifth Avenue in New York. Prior to that, he had worked for Coro Craft, also known as Coro. He was a designer there, so he knew what people liked, he knew how to get things made, and he knew the business and the market in general. He wasn't one of the big companies at the time, he was a smaller company, but he developed a following. People loved his handmade pieces, they loved his designs, and some of the big companies ended up copying him. They took notice of him as well. Even though he wasn't a big company, he did grow, and he ended up with manufacturing locations in a couple of other countries. Additionally, he did have some of the bigger companies make some of his pieces for him. Weiss is most known for having jewelry pieces with clusters of rhinestones and also crystals. He imported a lot of the crystals from Austria and was one of the very first people to start using Swarovski Aurora Borealis crystals. A lot of his pieces still retain a lot of sparkle and shine. They're usually done in a white base metal, although you can find them in gold as well, in a gold-based metal. And he's most known for floral designs. You'll find a lot of floral Weiss pieces, and mostly in brooches and earrings. That is what he mostly made, and they were sold as sets. You can still find some of those sets today. If you're really fortunate, you can find a parure. He did make necklaces and bracelets as well. So he did make entire parures as well, and you can still find them. In addition to flowers, you see a lot of leaves. He did insects, he did butterflies and ladybugs. He also did other animals. He's also known for his Christmas brooches. A lot of people just collect those, and they're in different Christmas themes and, of course, Christmas trees. He's especially known for his Christmas trees that have candles in them. And what you will find most throughout his whole line is earrings and brooches. The earrings are clips, and a lot of them go up, they go up the ear. Here you thought the crawler was something new. Not so. Weiss has been doing them for a long time. So they clip onto the back, and then they're intended to go up the ear. Sometimes I was looking online and I see people wearing them backwards. So you do have to know that a lot of them curve. There's a right and a left, and they are often meant to curve up the ear. He did also do dangle type earrings and big circular button earrings as well. As I mentioned, he did make necklaces and bracelets too. They can be a little harder to find, but they are out there. Weiss wasn't American, but he still made tiaras. So if you want to get your tiara on, there's a Weiss tiara out there for you. Weiss is most known for his rhinestones. Most of his pieces are covered in them. They're not always white. He's known for his black rhinestones, which he called black diamond. And he also has blues and reds and greens, different colors that he used. Even though this is what Weiss is most known for, not every piece of Weiss jewelry does have rhinestones. He also used enamel. This wasn't done as often, but you will find enamel pieces from Weiss. Weiss was founded in 1942, but it really flourished in the 50s and the 60s. And this is where you'll find most of the pieces from. I love these pieces. I love all the vintage ads showing the elegant women with their beautiful dresses in their Weiss jewelry. I think one of them said, "Why buy diamonds when you can have Weiss?" They're just a lot of fun. Albert Weiss retired in 1969, and he left his company to his son, Michael, to run. Unfortunately, that did not last long. The company closed in 1971, so you do not see Weiss jewelry after that. Well, you know I love Weiss jewelry. I'd love to hear what you think. What do you think about Weiss jewelry, and do you own any pieces? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. I would love to see you here again. Until next time.